think we're ready to start now. Been sitting here waiting to turn the camera on. This child outside, absolutely screaming at his mother. Swear words, calling her all sorts. I don't know how he's still living. If that was me, I would be dead. Anyway, doing my mission inspiration. And as you can see, I did coat this with 3 layers of gesso, and then I've put this tissue paper over the top that my lovely fiancé salvaged for me from some shoes. Love it. And first step this month is to add texture paste with a spatula. I do think I am just gonna go a bit random with this, maybe? I'm not sure. I think I'm just gonna sort of come in from the top and the bottom. I don't usually do this, I would normally use a stencil. Just building up some texture to begin with. Oh, this is Gold Medium's fibre paste. A bit pricey, but it's nice to work with. You see all the little lumpy fibres in it and stuff, and it absorbs paint really nicely. Is it paper? Acrylic polymer dispersion. And then maybe just a little bit in the middle. Here and there. Yeah, it says flexible film made with handmade paper appearance. You can use it as a ground if you want to, which means that, you know, your mediums will stick to it. You could use this instead of gesso or absorbent ground or something like that. Just put a little bit on the edge there. I think that will do. Yep. That's off my spatula. Now I'm going to have to let that dry before I go on to the next step, which is to add some spray colours. Try that again. I've got a message. Actually, let me just silence my phone. There we go, because I think I might get another text back. So yeah, it's dry to the touch. It's not dry underneath, but it should be dry enough to just put some sprays on. I think I'm just going to put a little bit of the sepia down. I realise that this is kind of moss coloured anyway, so sepia is not got much pigment in it at all. Should probably put some more ink in that. But that will help it move without. Let's add in something. Oh my goodness. Neighbours have got music playing again. So yeah, add some yellow. And I'm going to add a little bit of this Lindy spray, which is Yellow Rose of Texas. This is a drop of let's put some more in there actually. This De La Rowney sepia ink. I need to put some more in. In just some water. other alcohol links are surgical spirits with, can you see those? They're the insides of markers. That doesn't go on there. That goes on there. You know, like children's felt tips. And then I'm just going to add some of this Lindy spray. Look how vibrant those colours are. That's the Yellow Rose of Texas. And then I will get that dry and I might have to shut my window. Be right back. So the next step is to add some drips or splatters, and I'm going to go for drips. I'm going to water this paint down. Clean the spatula. Or clean-ish. Okay, that looks quite good consistency. That's going to run nicely, hopefully. And I'm going to hold the page up. Hopefully hold it so you can see it. And I'm going to put the paint on top. Whoop, and everywhere else. So clumsy. Right, and then I just want to get the, let's try and keep this in frame, some water and spray it. Gonna dry that, and then I'm gonna do it from the other side, so I'll be right back. Okay, so let's just pop out just a little bit more paint and some water. I haven't dripped paint like this for ages. I used to do it all the time in my journals when I first started journaling. I think after a while when I got my Lindy sprays, they were just easier to do, but something to be said for after I've been painting, I think. Gives a nice effect. Some water, disperse it a little bit. going to leave that at that. Give it a quick draw. Yeah, the next step is to add natural texture or fibres, and I'm a bit stuck on that one, so I'm going to have a think. I'll be back. Right, now my battery's charged. I've decided on my focal image, and I want to stamp her before I carry on with the page. So that she can dry and everything before I colour her. Let's keep an eye on the time, because I've got some dye sitting in my hair. Okay. Beautiful. And I've just stamped her onto some wax paper with pigment ink. Okay. Pop that to one side. So the next step was to add natural texture or something. So I found these leaves that I've had for a while. I thought they were really nice. Don't want to use the big ones. These are from our Acer in the garden. The little ones. So, use gel medium. So, just see if I can get my watch to stand up there. There we go. Ooh. Never used anything like this in an art journal page before, so this will be a nice change. I've had them for a while, like I say, I just didn't know what to do with them. I'm going to go over the top to seal and protect the leaves. Here in it. Let's get rid of that. Oops. Stems are going to be a bit tricky, I think. Oops, a bit broke off. Because they're dry, they can be quite brittle. off work this week. Got no plans to go out anywhere really. But I've got a lot of birthdays this week, so I'm probably going to be baking a lot of cakes. I've got one that I definitely want to do for my sister. I'm just hoping I get the time to bake it. Obviously I'm off a week, so I'll get the time. It's just being able to get into the kitchen when there's nobody else in there. Annoying thing about living with your family. I love all the pieces, but sometimes you just want to get in and do stuff, and they want to get in and do stuff, and you know what I mean? Okay, so I think that looks really nice. I didn't notice that one of the words is forest until I was looking earlier. I was like, oh, that's kind of perfect. I was thinking forest when I did the green sprays and the green drips. I thought it was very foresty. So, we're kind of going to go for woodland fairy sort of thing. And now I need to get my markers out. Oh, give me a second, I just need to get over there. Pull this drawer out. Grab my markers. And I really do need to find out if I can get some of the refill for the whatchamacallit. I forget what it's called. The blender ink that's in each thing. So yeah. In a later step, there's some cutouts. You can add torn book paper or cutouts. I'm going to add those. So I'm going to try and match the colours a little bit. Now then, let's see if we've got any blender in this one. Don't think so. Oh, maybe. Don't think the ink is dried though, because it's on the wax paper, so I'm going to have to be really careful. I do actually want her facing that way, so we will see what that looks like when we stick her upside down. But I'm going to continue to colour on this side because it's the rough side. Dry a little bit as well. The chameleon ink, as I say, I'm working on wax paper. It's the first time I've done this on wax paper. I'm still playing around with wax paper, see how I like it. So, yeah. I think we'll do her dress teal to match the teal in the flowers. I'm not really gonna worry too much about blending on this one. I'm just gonna colour her. Where am I? Should I do a little bit blending? Let's see if there's any ink in this one. Doesn't need a lot anyway because it's only a small area. No, there's no ink in that blender. Never mind, can you see what I'm doing? Yeah. I'm trying not to move my head too much so I don't get dye everywhere. I'm not sure if this is the first time I've ever done this with my hair, and I'm really nervous. My hair's quite a dark colour, so it doesn't take the really funky colours that I really, really want very well, so I decided to try this one. It's a turquoise, and it's supposed to work on darker hair, so we'll see. Let's use a slightly warmer yellow for the middle flower. And then we need a purple. I'd really like to get this more of a pale colour, so let's see if we can do that. Not sure. Sort of. Around here. So a bit more blending fluid. So I'm starting to use my Instagram account now that I have my new tablet. I'm starting to post some photos, not many at the minute. But if I do end up baking some cakes, well, there will definitely be some kind of cake pictures on there. So if you want to have a look at the cakes I bake, check it out. I'm just going to test over here that one. I can never remember which one's the best one for skin tone. I'm definitely not an expert colourist. I do enjoy colour every now and then. I'm in the mood. Right. Is she still wet? I think a quick blast of heat gun wouldn't hurt. So I'll go away and do that and I'll be right back. Okay, so she's dry. I'm going to tear around her. The straight edge at the bottom. Is this matte here? Should we use that? Yeah. I like that. She's the matte because it's out. The gel, I mean. Put her down. I think maybe I should have done her on tissue because that's not disappearing as much as I would like. Maybe it will when it dries, I don't know. But she is there. And I think next, is it Scribbly Text next or Shapes next? Let's just see if I can find it. Nice and quick. Mission Inspiration. Albums. May. Right, so add natural texture of fibres, add one or more focal images, and then add the handwritten text. Yep, so I'm going to need this to be dry before I do that, because I'm going to cut my pen otherwise. Yeah, I will get this with a heat gun and I'll be right back. Okay, so there's still some bits that aren't dry, but it should be dry enough where I want to write, I hope. Yeah. There we go. So that is that one. What's next in the list? Illegible handwritten text. Add book text or paper shape. So that's when our flowers come in. That one kind of didn't cut my die cutting machine properly. User error. Across the bum. Is that too uniform, maybe? I like that. That's fine. Okay. Here we go. Again, just sticking with the gel medium because it's here. A lot of texture on there. So this is some music book paper that I just wiped off some paintbrushes off on one day. Some lilac paint and teal paint. And it was really pretty. I don't know if it really goes on this page, but I don't care, I like it. It's all nice. That really is all that matters when you do an art journal page. If you like it, it's good. If you don't like it, Learn from it. Coming off the page a little bit. Yeah, off the page a little bit. It's quite a big one. Interestingly, there is no prompt to put a title on this page or anything like that. You can do if you want to. I'm not sure if I'm going to or not. I really don't know. I usually do. I usually like to have words on my artwork. Kind of gives it a meaning for me. Although, you know, sometimes you don't always have to spell it out, do you? Okay. I like that very much. Now, what's the last one? Is it border? Are we on to the last one? Book text, and then finish with the border. Yes, I think I'm going to wait a little bit for everything to dry before I add a border. So, let me just stick that bit of leaf down that's poking up there. Oh, I'll just break it off. Not doing very well with that leaf, am I? Okay, I'm gonna leave that. And I will be back when it's dry. Okay, let's quickly finish this off because I've got cakes in the oven. It's the next day. It's getting late yesterday, so I couldn't finish this. Right, so I've got this little stamp and stays on. I've placed it in the middle of the top so I can line it up nicely. Beautiful. And then line it up again. Oh, the right way around. Again. Line it up again on this side. And then we'll go down the side. There we go, that's that done. It's not perfect, but it's pretty. Oh, got it. Oof. Thought they were going to be stuck forever then. So, as you can see, I've gone around the fairy's outline with a black pen just to make her a bit bolder. I'm not sure if I want any words. Good in these stickers. Live a spirited life, that would do. Extra bit there. Spirited. Life. There we go. That is done. It's just my sister. She's my daughter to draw her pillowcases over the top. Okay. So, yes, that's done. Although, actually, I think I need some splatters. White to lift the page. Where did I put that white paint a minute ago? There it is. Got it. Don't need a lot. Some water. Too much water, but hey ho. Just think it's quite dark up here, and I don't want it dark. So if we add a bit of splatter. Go. Sorry. And then that gives it a bit of a magical feel too. It's like the spirits in the forest. There we go. So I hope you enjoyed that. I did. One thing I did want to do, if I can just squeeze past you here, is grab my, where are they? They're in here somewhere. Oh. Yeah. Oop. Tipping everything out. I'm sure they're down here. Oh no, they're in the other drawer. Sorry, my head. Dovecraft 3D pills. Get it. go in here. Excuse me if my head's in the way as it is. Let me just sit back a little bit. Really delicate. Oops. Try that again. I only want them really, really small. Preferably rounded. We just need one more tiny little one. And that's that. Oh, that looks really nice, actually. Yes, okay. Now she's finished. And I'm going to leave that to dry. And get on with my cakes and editing this video at the same time. So, yes, thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed that, and I'll see you soon. Bye, guys.